Hi guys. So, yeah, Prometheus. What to say about this movie? Well, let's start at about telling about the movie theater and stuff like that. I went to the theater in town, and I went to a late night screening for a change, and there were some people who were more than the Avengers and Men in Black, but we've seen those in the afternoon. So yeah, I was with the same friend as I saw the Avengers with, so I was not alone this time. What do I say about this movie? Let's start with the 3D. The 3D was not as good as, well, definitely not as good as the Avengers, but also not as good as Men in Black, actually. To be honest, it was there, but not necessary. They could have done it without 3D, but of course, you know, the money, I understand, but I don't like it. They could have done it without the 3D. I mean, they're doing, I mean, in this movie theater, at least, I'm not sure if they is it or if it is around the globe, but they're doing Snow White and the Huntsman without 3D, and that trailer looked nice. And then the story, spoilers, by the way. So the movie starts with Voldemort. I'm serious. The guy at the start and at the beginning of the movie looks like fucking Voldemort. I'm not shitting you. And he dies straight away. And it's made clear that it's on Earth and that he kind of creates life. And something like that, I guess. And then we go ahead in time into the near future, and they're discovering this rock paintings that they've seen before but are older than they ever saw. And well, they're all pointing towards somewhere in space where they think our creators came from. And it's something that I've heard theories about before, that we're kind of created by these alien beings from somewhere. It could be true. I'm not saying that. Yeah, it's kind of interesting to make a movie from that direction, and so they apparently plan to go out there. But that's the thing. That's one of the things I promise I had to put this movie is that you don't see what they had to do to. They could have done something to show, okay, you know, we're telling these people and they're saying, okay, we want to fund the research and we have this ship and we're flying there and we will be flying over there, and you're not doing that. All of a sudden you're basically at the destination where the rest of the movie portrays. And then the movie starts, and it goes on, and on, and on. Hang on. And I guess there is some story in it, but
it's Joe dragging and dragging and dragging.
And then the worst break. And I seriously thought, do I still want to see the rest of this movie, or do I just want to go home? And my friend kind of had the same problem. We're both like, you know, we're gonna sit it out. We still have faith in this movie, and finally, after the break, the first people die. Finally, but the, you know, and it's not about the death of those people. It's just that finally something happens. And then again, the movie is kind of dragging along, and there are some good plot directions that the movie is going in, like with the android. There is an android on the ship, and he is he is kind of portrayed as a sort of bad guy, but you could also understand why he's doing the bad things, but I don't really see his motivation. So all of a sudden the android did have feelings, and his feelings were hurt by the guy he infected with the alien goo. He infects someone with that alien thing to take revenge on that man, but he risked the life of the rest of the crew by it, while he also had kind of a crush on the female doctor head character, but he was also kind of fascinated and interested in making sure she became pregnant and gave birth to the being that was inside of her, and that he was also kind of fascinated, relieved that she survived and managed to get that thing out of her. I don't really see what the motivation of the android was. But maybe that's just me. Maybe I just missed something in the movie that's And then the old man, the head of the company, the man that funded the research and they were working for all of a sudden appears to be on the ship. What wasn't a big surprise. It was supposed to be a surprise. The camera was really like, there he is! And then they kind of meet up with one of the aliens that kind of created them, but kind of created us, but then were planning to destroy us, and instead of at least saying something, he didn't say anything. Well, they did have a way to communicate with the alien, or at least they thought they had. Nothing happened, and so then the alien is leaving to fulfill his mission, but then they also find out that actually the aliens they kind of changed their mind about destroying the human race, but that alien didn't know it because he was in chronostasis or something. It was all really, really fake, and it didn't make too much sense for me. And I think they're kind of aiming, because they also didn't really answer the question that was the big question that was asked in the movie. And I think they're kind of aiming towards a towards the second part. And that's okay, you can do that. If you kind of make clear that you're actually going to do it. But they're not really making that clear. They're setting it up in a way that it could go both ways. They could get out of not making a second part, and they could, yeah, pick up a second part from there where the movie ends. And that is where my main problem is. I would have liked to see more clearly if the movie was going to have a follow-up, or I wanted to have an answer to the big question that they wanted to be have, they wanted to have answered, that why did the aliens create us? It was kind of hinted that maybe, but still, and why did they want to destroy us, and why did they change their mind? That was one of the main problems I had with this movie. The pacing of the movie was also terrible for me. The 3D wasn't that good. The motivation of the android didn't make sense to me. So overall, it wasn't as good as I expected it to be. However, it wasn't a bad movie. I actually had fun. The whole movie together, it kind of worked. But not as good, not as much as The Adventures and The Man in Black. Definitely not as much as The Adventures. The Adventures was big, and it just couldn't top The Adventures, clearly. And it was a decent movie, and I had my fun, but it could have been better. I saw a few misses there, and it kind of pisses me off. Not really. I mean they did their best, and they obviously put a lot of effort in this movie, and you can see that. You can see that they thought about the initial story for, well, if there were these intelligent designers that engineers that created humankind, how would they look like? Would they look like us? Would they be bigger? Would they be smaller? And I'm not going to tell you how the human thing that created us looks like. Of course, I don't have to tell you, because you already know that it's kind of the story before Aliens, sort of. So that of course, the movie ends with the first alien that's kind of created from all the things that were at that base thing there. So that's not another surprise. That's something we knew that would happen. Another thing where the movie could have done better. I mean, yeah.
I guess it's something that they expect to be done, but they could have done it in a way where we all would be like, what the fuck?
And they didn't do it.
The anticlimax of the movie, how they ended the movie, I mean, the first part of the ending was epic. I mean, great idea to do it like that, like flying the flying the human ship into the alien ship like a bullet and tearing apart the ship. Awesome idea. Love it. Then that the alien still lived. Yeah. They do that in other movies as well, so why not in Prometheus? Overall, again, I had my fun. It wasn't me. It wasn't a movie for me. But I can definitely see a crowd for this and people enjoying it more than we did. So that's my thoughts about Alien. Prometheus, sorry. If you have any comments on the movie, tell me, by all means, tell me what you thought about Prometheus. Post it below. I'm going to call it a night. It's 12 a.m. here. Good hour to call it a night. I see you all later. Bye, guys.